these too small for us?
No.
That's what they're made for. It's a family car.
Do we put our head in here?
Nope. Well.
There you go.
I've used them before.
Hey, where's my thing? I think it's here. Put your hand!
Yeah. So
this is the key. We can
hear you.
That's the key to the car.
Okay, I'm recording already. Hey boys, how do you think it is back there?
Great!
Okay. Wow, large dash.
So as soon as you walk up to the car, it runs now. This is a cool feature. I can adjust our ride height.
Uh-huh.
So if you watch the car in front, you'll see we'll start rising right away. Feel it going up?
Yeah, I can feel it.
I can drop it right down.
Oh, yeah. We in the winter, we probably want it higher than low, right?
Well,
yeah, sweat. Is it out of your reach?
It should be right beside you.
No, it's on the floor.
It fell on the floor, did it? Okay.
Yeah, even if we set it to high, it'll, as we start driving for aerodynamics, it'll start to drop.
Okay. Can we adjust the radio off? Oh yeah, there we go. And the front trunk is empty too, right?
Yeah.
So that leaves the trunk as a passenger space.
A lot different ride than the E-Rap, eh?
Yeah, it's a little, feels a little bit different.
So this car, on a $10 charge, will do 450 to 500 kilometers. So on a level 2 90 amp, that's about 5 to 7 hours charge
cool.
time.
And I haven't tested to see how the heater is on the defog right now, then, I guess?
Yeah, so
okay.
Let's go into... It's got lots of heat, this car.
Oh yeah.
So I've been driving all day and it's affected about 50 to 75 kilometer range, it seems like.
With the heater.
With the heater on all day.
Okay. Oh yeah, there's an energy consumption chart there on the dash.
Yeah, so I can blow that up even bigger.
Yeah. Oh yeah, okay.
So it shows.
Projected range. Is that 79 remaining or?
Well, depending on how we drive and with the heat and everything like that, yeah.
Yeah.
But it's got 135 kilometers. So if we drive slow, we'll get it.
Right.
That's just going by how I've been driving before, which...
Uh-huh.
It's been a few test drives with some people, so... And when you regenerate, it'll do actually 60 kilowatt. Peavey Mart, we'll plug it in so we can still show it charging and
okay.
Because then on the screen it'll come up like how many amps and everything like that.
Cool. Let's see the dash. Oh, there it is. There's a button for that. I got it.
But this car's got 83,000.
Nice. So it's definitely broken in at 80,000.
Yeah. But does electrical motor really break in, or is it just always?
Exactly. There's no rings or pistons to to set.
Yeah.
Comes factory broken in.
That's right.
More construction here.
Yeah.
Right beside the pump.
I can't remember which ones they are.
Hey boys, how's it going?
Great!
You having fun waving at people?
Yeah.
Are they waving back?
No.
Oh, okay, maybe they don't see you.
What Peavey is they know?
They probably wonder what kind of people we are letting kids ride around in the trunk, in the rumble seat. Oh, it's got a full sunroof, oh, yeah. Basically.
Let's show you that bad boy if I can remember.
Finding it. Sunroof.
You got a sunroof?
Yep.
For real?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's too cold.
Not a good day for it outside, but here, let's me. Yeah. Let's me poke my head out anyway.
It even shows the seats on there, hey?
Yeah.
Like, it's pretty detailed.
So the other night we had my condo board meeting, annual general meeting, mm-hmm. and I managed to get a motion passed that will investigate solar energy in the coming year, especially if our budget isn't. And it's, there were a few people that were like, sort of like, well, why even bother? And I was like, well, there's a lot of reasons to bother.
Yeah.
One of the big ones is our finances. Another idea suggested for raising property values would be to install new carpets, which are sort of needed right now. And that's not a bad idea, but if you look at it the way I do, where you can invest about $10,000 in some solar energy right now, then in 10 years you get that $10,000 back approximately, mm-hmm. and then you buy your carpets with that money.
Right.
And then you get both.
Well, and the thing that people don't look at is they upgrade their home, spend $50,000 to upgrade at that value. But in 2 years, that value's gone.
Yeah.
You know, so.
Yeah, I mean, like, who's ever heard of making money on carpets? The only way you can cash in on it is if you, it looks like he wants over. Looks like, or the only way you cash in is if you sell. And then you don't have your condo anymore. But you can actually get the value of your solar panels back, plus the energy that you're producing. But a lot of people don't know what's possible right now.
A while with this rebate ending on the end of the month. It's been crazy.
Busy, eh?
Like, I can't even.
Well, I need to hear from your electrician.
Well, we soon. Can put everything in without that.
Okay.
We don't need that. That's something we can. And what I'll do is. Just because, you know, it's pretty damn cool. You know, after driving this, I don't know how I'm going to get back into my gas vehicle.
Yeah.
Really, it's going to be hard to have that noise pollution, you know, the tailpipe emission, everything about it. Knowing that this per kilometer costs more for tires than it would for electricity.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, one of my buddies was saying he'd really miss his truck if he didn't have it, because the news was bragging that gas has gone below $1 a liter, mm-hmm. and I'm like, don't let that fool you.
Yeah.
You can have it a lot better than that, and missing your truck isn't going to mean a choice between putting gas in it or not soon.
Well, you know, once we have the Via truck, the van. Best Western will have their van probably the next few months, their hybrid van. Even my truck will be coming, and that's 100 miles to the gallon it gets with the combination of battery and generator.
Meanwhile, in the back seat, I can hear the kids are winning a race on Mario Kart.
No, I got Mario Party.
Oh, Mario Party. Okay, sorry. I was mistaken. Can you hold that up again? Oh, one of you is playing Mario Kart, so I wasn't totally fooled.
But you know, that's a good option back there to have those seats with the five-point harness for the children, so you don't have to spend more money on car seats and putting in and out.
Yeah, that's, I know, that's what we were just about to throw the booster seats in here when you mentioned that they've already got something built in for the two kids.
No, it's, you know, it's a 7-seater family car.
A 7-seater car.
Yeah.
You have to say that again so that it sinks in.
Yeah, because I know that's Brooke's thing now, is, you know, the minivan we've always needed because of the kids. Well, we can do it now with this.
Yeah, with a luxury sports car.
That's right.
So they say they have a hardware and a whole lot more, and they mean it now because they've got electric car charging. Apparently the place to shop if you have a Tesla.
Free charging while you shop. It's even painted green for us.
Ah, yes. We're at Peavey Mart.
We're gonna have a quick charge. Give the car a little juice.
We're just across from Princess Auto.
This will do 100 amp, but it'll regulate down to what this car needs. And there we go. It's flickering green around the charger, telling you that it's active and live.
Oh yeah. You can charge up while someone's in the vehicle safely.
Yes.
And was it still running, or do you have to shut it off completely?
No, it's just warming up. You won't be able to drive, but it will be able to warm the vehicle still.
Oh,
so wow. In the morning, what I'd do is turn the amperage down overnight and let the heat be on, and that way in the morning your batteries are hot, the interior's warm, everything, and then you're ready to go.
Mm-hmm. You can actually do a remote start without wasting 10 minutes of gas or something.
And instant heat. It's an electric heat, right? So it doesn't have to warm up any fluids.
It doesn't have to burn gas for the engine to warm up and get byproduct waste heat with inefficiency.
Heat,
yeah.
So, and then to shut it off, all we have to do now is pull the trigger. I'm going to have to pop.
Okay. Ah, then it turns red, or?
Oh, it froze up here. I had to wash it.
Oh, yeah.
Because it's taking everybody.
Well, there's a little difficulty.
It's not usually like this.
Oh, there it goes. It was probably stalling.
Push in and then pull.
Yeah, push and then pull.
So, then, the button, those door handles flush off, so aerodynamics.
Oh yeah.
Push on and come out.
Cool. Can you get out? I don't know, I'm gonna open the back. Let's see, how does this open? Oh. I'm just saying hi. You wanna get out? We're just leaving again. We were just charging up quick. First car I've been in that actually feels like it's still from the future.
Yeah. Yeah, I took my buddy who has a Lamborghini, and he's I want one.
No gas stations for us in this car.
That was the gas station, the electrical grid.
Yes, if you have gas station,
you don't need it. The best one is organic, using solar power to fill the car.
Really?
Yes.
Yeah, we're gonna have solar panels up on the garage this summer.
Yeah, adding the electric car to the solar network drops your payback not quite in half, but pretty close.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, I never really, till I started playing with these more and calculating all that, it was like, you know.
I knew cars would suck it bad, just because that's how they work. My friend, again, with the truck, he's big, the idea is to have, you know, electric charged vehicles. And I said, yeah, you can do it. But like, I was looking at the numbers 4 years ago with my dad's array, and I was like, I don't possibly see how that the numbers that were for electric cars even 4 years ago, that we're going to be able to have solar charged homes with only a 15 panel array doing both the home's electricity and a car. You'll need to have a 15 panel array just for your car. You do you?
Yeah.
Well, depending on the car, like the eRAV there, 3 kilowatts basically, depending on how much, really it depends how much driving you do, right?
Yeah, I mean, if you're doing 10 kilometers each way, maybe you'll make it, but if you're doing any 200 kilometer days, you're gonna need something different.
Well, it's like my friend, they live in White City, to buy this, to charge it, they'd only have to charge it once a week.
Wow.
You know, for the amount of driving they do.
Yeah.
Look at how far.
Yeah.
Traction control.
Because it throws you right back in these seats, even just to give it a quarter throttle.
Yeah.
Voltage regulator, not throttle.
Voltage regulator. Yeah, I don't think our lingo is going to change anytime soon. This is how you can still get a penny for your thoughts.
Yeah. No, it's true, because all day, you know, people are, how if you step on the gas, no gas.
Yeah, if somebody releases a hit record, you still know what they've released.
Exactly. But yeah, no, it's funny because, you know, I'm trying to get people to understand that, but it still all means the same thing. We can even put the camera on and see who's tailgating us.
Oh, yeah. Okay, that's the backup camera.
Yeah, this car's got everything, 3G, you name it.
Yeah, I was noticing the 3G Bluetooth logo at the top there. Oh.
So that's nice that the car has its own, you know, 3G setting.
And with no switches and such, right, there's nothing to wear out as much, hopefully. And you can't drop this iPhone.
No. Well, and that's the beauty. This car's got about 83,712 kilometers.
And it still looks like new on the front here.
And, you know, it's never had an issue. And it's driven, this car is mainly almost probably 90% of its life's been in Canada. So, you know, it's seen two harsh winters. One of them in Saskatchewan, so.
Do you know who won? 47001.
It's funny though, the looks people give you when you and they realize what you're driving.
Yeah, I saw a couple of these driving around California when I was there in April and May.
Yeah.
And I even saw a brand new one in the Tesla store in Santa Monica.
Oh, yeah.
Just looking around Santa Monica, they have, it's sort of like a Scarth Street mall, but it's longer, it goes for many blocks, and one of the stores was the Tesla store.
Yeah. Yeah, same with Miami, they have one on the strip there. But that's why we have it here, you know, to take people for a drive, to show them the difference, and it is feasible here.
Yeah. I don't have heat on the seat. Oh, I do have. Okay, there it is. It seemed to be warm anyway.
No, I haven't had it on. It's just, that's the normal, just the heat.
Yeah, then that's even better than that RAV4 the other week.
I love that RAV4. It's 4-week drive. It's, but you know, this has got a touch of class to it, right? You know,
yeah.
Even the leather seats there, the stitching and everything is just a really good quality. You know, start weighing everything together. These are just, you know, same price as buying any of these other cars. If you don't have that gas, the oil changes.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's a big expense that you don't really account for.
The repair.
Which you know, the biggest thing to go on these would be down the road with the batteries. But, you know, who knows, in the future you may not even own your, like, who knows where it's going to go.
Yeah.
And right now, lithium ion, they're good for 20 years. 10 anyway, with warranty, I believe.
With laptop batteries, it doesn't work out that way, but maybe they've changed the use of them a bit.
Yeah. No, these, it's not that they have so many charges or anything. It's, you know, it's just you have to maintain it properly also. There's no charging. That's why this is so important, is to have a charging schedule, right? Like, I can set a schedule.
Ah.
Once I stop, it'll have a schedule where it tells me that at these times it has to be bulked up or an extended range charge, things like that.
Oh, okay.
And then on this car, it's nice too, because I can change how much amps I put into it. I can tone it down.
So it does that charge more slowly, though?
A little slower, yeah. Okay. So over the night, you know, in the morning, the batteries are still charging and warm.
Orange and the blue on the dash must be regarding...
The blue is your speed.
Okay.
The orange is how many kilowatts you're using when you're driving.
Okay.
And then when I let off, that's my regeneration. So okay. My braking.
Right.
So it'll do up to, on the highway, if I let off, I'll get 60 kilowatt out of it.
Yeah, because when you're not accelerating, it's trying to recoup the loss and put it back in the battery. And so instead of just slowing down by friction on the road, it's actually slowing down by running the engine backwards, so to speak.
Charging,
yeah. Yeah, the motor is going the other.
Kind of the same as a wind turbine. If you put power to it, it'll spin it, and if you have the wind turn it and put it through an inverter, well, then it produces power.
Oh, okay. I didn't know that about wind turbines.
Yeah.
You can turn them into fans, then.
I've seen it done.
Right now, the wind turbine at the university appears to be down, which annoys me, because it's an engineering experiment that they haven't put too much effort into, it appears.
Yeah.
Well, thanks very much, James, for the ride in the Tesla Model S.
You betcha. I told you when it came, I'd take you, because, you know, you have helped blog and spread the word, so...
And now my seat is heating up, so I better turn that down.
It'll get hot.
It's fingerprint sensitive, apparently. Yeah.
It's been an interesting day driving this around all day.
It's a hard life, isn't it?
Well, some days, yes.
Jim Elliott's house is just ahead.
Yeah. Same with David Orban.
Yep. On Lindsay.
Yeah.
Big solar and wind turbine promoter.
Yeah, his turbine's been down for how many years?
Yeah. He's still got the solar as far as I know. What? He does that annual solar tour that I'm fond of.
Yeah. Yeah, if everything works out, I want to go grab Phil and take Phil and watch him for a ride.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he's down in the south end of the city.
Yeah.
There's bud riding in the back.
Yeah, and then they just stow down there.
Oh, cool.
And then you got lots of trunk room. He's going to get to push the button.
And then I'll show you the front
one. Okay, push that button.
There's a front
and then
trunk.
Jump off.
There's a
front trunk, yes.
There's a front trunk. There's no engine in the thing.
No.
Whoa, how does it go anywhere? Do you know? Do you know how it goes anywhere?
A battery,
yeah. And
it'd be pretty cold to sleep in there, and probably not too comfortable. I shouldn't say that. It might be comfortable. Snug. Snug as a bug.